My name is Jenny Morgan and I'm the director here at Gentle Shore Wildlife Centre. The sanctuary was originally started by my late father, Rob Smith, who was a gamekeeper originally and then started doing the rehab of the wild birds of prey, and then he opened a sanctuary here and started in taking the other animals, and we lost him 9 years ago, and then I took over and carried on his work today. We started off originally as a bird of prey hospital in our back garden. That then turned into taking in unwanted captive bred birds of prey as well as the wild injured ones. That then turned into taking in other animals, so we moved over to the base here in Eccleshall. Because we're open to the public, we have to have a zoo licence, but that then meant that we could take in other animals as well. So over the last 20 years, we've now started taking in exotic animals that have been pets, animals from laboratories, animals from zoos that have closed down, and that sort of thing. And today we still treat and rehab the wild birds of prey, but we also do a lot of rescue and rehabilitation of exotic and captive bred animals as well. This is still a family-run sanctuary, so my mum does all the paperwork, my twin sister is one of the keepers here, and then we have a band of volunteers that help us look after the animals and do all the maintenance. Because we rely on donations from the public and admission fees this year, unfortunately the weather has been quite poor during the school holidays, which means visitor numbers have been down. Everybody's struggling for money, so donations are down, which means our takings are down, and obviously costs are going up, so electricity, vet fees, bedding, that sort of thing. So we're really struggling at the moment, and we're sort of really scraping to see if we can get through till the new year. We don't get any government funding or anything like that, and although we are a registered charity, because we're a very small registered charity, getting sponsorship and donations can be very hard. So we do go out and do collections, we do school talks, we charge admission to the centre, so that's something that helps with the funding and the day-to-day costs. And then space is a big issue as well. We could do with some more room, because we're constantly being asked to take more animals in and just don't have the room. So money and space are the two main issues that we have. Unfortunately, the future for the animals here would be very bleak if we were to close down. We are a rescue centre, which means the animals are here as a last resort in the first place. And we do have a contingency plan, so we would be able to find homes for the majority of the animals. But unfortunately for those that wouldn't be able to find homes, the older ones, ones with sort of special needs, the more strange species that need specialist care, the only option would be to have them put to sleep. I have no idea what I would do if the centre were closed down. When we opened, I was 11 years old and would come up in school holidays and weekends. Started here full time when I left high school, and I've been here ever since. So it would have to be something animal-y. I couldn't possibly do an office job. I'm no good at anything like that, so I don't know what I'd do.